factors affecting growth. This is lecture 2 on growth and development. Objective, we are going to discuss external factors affecting growth in the plant, animal, and microorganism in general. We are going to look on internal factors that include genetic makeup and influence to growth. Also, we are going to outline the hormone that stimulates growth in the plant and animal. Factors affecting growth. These are all conditions that may either stimulate growth of organism or inhibit growth of organism to take place. So they have positive and negative effect on growth, that is to stimulate growth or to inhibit growth. We can group them into two groups. We have internal factors and external factors. Internal factors are those that present within the organism with itself, but the external factors include all the environmental factors that can affect growth. In the external factors that affecting growth, we have nutrients, we have temperature, we have light, we have the accumulation of metabolic waste, and we have pH. Those are external factors of growth. First one is nutrient availability. We know that nutrients are essential for growth. Example, protein food is essential for growth since it promotes formation of new tissue, which increases the body mass. Hence, a body that gets all nutrients in the correct amount is well grown, because there is enough energy and nutrients for body to synthesize new tissue. But a body that have a deficiency of nutrients have a standard growth since there is no enough material and energy for it to synthesize new tissue. Example, kwashiorkor in children is due to deficiency of protein. That's why the children is manifested with the stunted growth. The second one is temperature. As we know that temperature influences the biological activity in our bodies. Temperature influences the enzymatic activities. Since enzymes are very sensitive to temperature, thus body grow only at optimum temperature for enzymatic activities, because enzymes function at optimum temperature. At high temperature, enzymes are denatured because they are protein and they are sensitive to temperature. Once the enzymes are denatured due to high temperature, they are no longer performing their normal metabolic activity and the process of growth is stopped. And at a low temperature, enzymes are inactive and they catalyze slowly the metabolic activity and the rate of growth in your body. Light. We know that light is essential for photosynthesis in a plant, which is the process that the plant uses to synthesize food that is used to provide energy for the synthesis of tissue for the growth of a plant body. A plant placed in a total darkness have abnormal growth because it does not receive enough light. This is called a theolating. As you see in the diagram, we have two plants, the first one, the second. The first one has been grown in an area where it receives enough light, but the second one grew in an area which receives a small amount of light. That's why the second plant show abnormal growth. This is called etiolation, which is the abnormal elongation of the stem of plant due to lack of light. The first one is accumulation of metabolic waste. We know that some metabolism produce waste which are toxic and may inhibit growth. This effect can be explained in bacteria and yeast. When the population of bacteria and yeast is high in a culture, they produce a lot of metabolic waste that retard the growth of this microorganism. In the graph, you see that this is graph to illustrate the growth in bacteria. Initially, there is a high rate of growth, but it reaches a point that called the stationary phase, in which the number of death is equal to the number of cell division to replace those cells that have been died. But the death phase is when the number of cells die is greater than the number of cells that are produced. This is due to the accumulation of metabolic waste as the population of bacteria has become great. So the metabolic waste causes the change of environmental condition that hinders the process of growth of bacteria. The last external factor is pH. As we know that pH is determined by the hydrogen ion concentration. So when we are talking about the pH, we are talking about the pH that's surrounding the cell. As we know that many metabolic activity within the cell are affected by the pH of environment, because enzymes that catalyze those metabolic activities have a narrow range of pH that can work best. So change in the pH affects the normal activity of a cell, hence they affect growth of the body. Thus, a given species of plant and animal with its own pH range in it to grow best. Example, see some plants grow in acidic soil and other grow in alkaline soil. And some bacterial species do not grow in acidic condition. For example, once we want to inhibit growth of bacteria in our food, we just take a vinegar which is acidic and add it to our food. When we take vinegar and add it to our food, we create a acidic condition that is not favorable for the growth of bacteria. Now we come to the internal factors affecting growth. We have three internal factors affecting growth. The first one is genetic makeup. The second one is state of health of that organism. And the last one is the first one is genetic makeup. As we know that different species are made up of different genes, and there is a variation of gene within one species. So gene determine the extent of growth of that person. Some people are born with gene for tallness and other are born with gene for shortness. So we expect that person to grow differently because they are made of different genes. But genes work together with environmental factor to determine growth. Genes are influenced by the environmental factors in the determination of the overall growth effect in organism. We have two persons, the tallest one and the shortest one. This is due to the genetic makeup of that people. The second one is the state of health. As we know that the disease retards growth of the body, because disease is something that hinders the normal function of the body. So we expect that once a person gets sick, then there is no normal function of his or her body, so the process of growth is slow. But when a body has a good health, it grows well, and when the body has disease, it does not grow well. Example, children with sickle cell anemia always present with the growth retardation because sickle cell anemia hinders the normal growth process of the body. The last one is the hormone. As we know that in plants, we have three hormones that are growth promoters, which are auxin, gibberellins, and cytokinins. These are growth promoters because they increase rate of growth in a plant. For example, cytokinin stimulates the process of cell division in a plant. So, by doing so, it increases the rate of growth in the plant body. And their effect in growth can be explained when they are in excess or in a little amount. When they are in excess, they result into abnormal growth, and when they are in a little amount, it results also into the abnormal growth in a plant. In animal, we have growth hormone that is called somatotrophic hormone, which is from the anterior pituitary gland. Somatotrophic hormone has effect on growth. Also, we have thyroxine hormone from thyroid gland, which has also effect on growth by increasing metabolic activity in the body. And also the effect of this hormone can be explained in growth when they are in excess or in absence amount. When they are in absence, is that the abnormal growth, and when they are in excess, it is that also in the abnormal growth. We have two conditions. We have dwarfism and gigantism. Dwarfism is due to the deficiency of growth hormone, and gigantism is due to excess of growth the hormone in them. Thank you, please subscribe the channel so that to get new video notifications.